is Jeff Sutherland, and welcome to another edition of Jeff's Startalk Show. We're on the air with my partner D.W. Landingham and myself to open up with another classic celebration of an Abbott and Costello movie. This one was the last one they made for Universal, and the last of a series of Abbott and Costello Meet the Monsters. And this one, they meet the mummy. And Costello, you know, when they met the mummy, it was pretty scary.
That's right. And that was his mummy. It wasn't his mother. It was his mummy.
That's right. You know, and so the boy's best friend is his mummy.
That's right.
And we have a classic scenes from the Abbott and Costello feature. And we also have an interview with one of the stars of Abbott and Costello Meet the Mummy. And that's Michael Ansaro, who played the heavy. So you'll see his interview later on in the show as well. And so, tell you what, Costello, without further ado, let's get into Abbott and Costello Meet the Mummy, co-starring Michael Ansaro and Mary Winslow, and you're going to love it. 1955, Universal International, so stay tuned.
I'm going to cover my eyes now because I'm going to get scared.
Are you?
Well, I don't see her. Maybe we're too early, huh? Well, I've got enough money for hamburgers and coffee, and after we sell the medallion, we'll have steaks and potatoes. Come on, let's sit down. Waiter. Two hamburgers and two coffees, please.
Yes, sir. Very well, sir.
Hey, this is a good time to get the lowdown on that fake jewelry before we make a deal with that dame. Oh, waiter. Does this mean anything to you?
It means death. Death to whoever holds it.
Hey, you better get rid of that medallion. You heard what the waiter said? It's death to whoever holds it.
You know, Lou, I think it was a medallion that caused those characters to throw those knives at us.
You're so right. Boy, am I glad I feel good. I. Doom.
Flowers?
Flowers. How much are those flowers?
A dollar.
How much are these?
A dollar.
I ain't got no money.
No money?
Huh?
They're a little wilted. You can have them for nothing.
Oh.
Sorry, sir, when you put the flower on my tray, you accidentally put this jewelry on it.
Oh, no. Oh.
I will bring the coffee later.
Okay. Lou, isn't that a beautiful girl over there?
I believe this girl over here is much prettier.
Wait a minute. How can you compare this girl with that gorgeous creature over there? Why, it's ridiculous.
Just a minute. I still believe that that girl over there is much prettier.
I still say that girl over there is the prettiest girl in the place.
Would you mind if I try yours?
Enjoying the movie, Costello? Isn't that great, Abbott and Costello?
I missed a lot of it because I'm covering my eyes.
Yeah, I know. But you know what they always say. The man's best friend is his mummy.
Yeah, his mummy.
And
his mother, mummy.
And he's always, you know, I mean, he was always doing good in bandage work. You know,
that's
notice
right.
that. Yeah. Hey, you know what, Costello?
He must have had a lot of cuts on him.
I want to give you something because you've been my bosom pal for all these years.
Well, yeah, we've been
and
friends
I'm
going to
give
time.
You this wonderful medallion. It is the ancient medallion of Clarice.
The medallion of Clarice.
That's right.
Abbott, you've never given me anything like this before.
Well, I thought, you know, because we've been pals and everything.
It's very beautiful.
Yes. I know. Let's enjoy it.
Abbott, what's all the writing and little insignias on here?
Well, Costello, you really don't want to know that, do you?
Well, I would not ask you if I didn't want to know.
It doesn't mean a thing. It's some... Well, they claim it's a 1,000-year curse for them. For the man who holds the medallion. But it's nothing.
A curse? What kind of curse?
Well, death, whoever the one who holds it. But it doesn't mean anything to you.
Death to the one who holds it.
Yeah, that's right. Now, let's drink a punch. Well, let's drink a punch. Here is a cheers to you. What is that all about, Costello?
Don't want to die, Abbott.
Hey, you want my audience to think that I'm a cheapskate. Now, I got this medallion.
That's okay.
It's the secret medallion of Clarice. Mm-hmm. And you're going to have it. Now, give it. Take it. Now, let's drink our punch.
Oh, hey, look, a yellow-bellied sapsucker.
A yellow-bellied sapsucker in Bill May's studio?
I never seen one of those here before.
No, I never seen one either, and I can't understand. Hey, let's drink up. Here's
sure.
Beer for whatever ails you.
Here we go.
Wait. I forgot to tell you.
What's that?
I forgot to tell you. Look at Bill May's lamp. Isn't that beautiful? All the nice
you
colors.
You know, I was noticing that. That's a very nice lamp.
Yes, it's a great, great lamp. I enjoy that lamp.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay, let's drink up.
Oh, hey, you know what? Bill May is a very good cameraman, and he knows about electronics. Did you see his new camera over there?
No, I didn't see that. I really like that. Yes, indeed.
Mm-hmm. It was very nice.
Uh-huh. Well, I tell you what, look at the beautiful staircase that he has in his studio.
Yeah, he told me he finished that himself with the varnish and all that stuff.
Very nice. He's an old varnish man. Okay, let's drink up.
Okie dokie.
All right, here we go. Wait a minute. How do I end up with this again? Costello, once and for all, you put it in your pocket. It is your medallion. There. Now, I want you to keep that medallion.
I don't want to die, Abbott.
Well, Costello, you're already dead from the neck up. Let's enjoy the punch.
You know, I don't have to sit here and be insulted.
And what are you going to do about it?
I'm going to sit over there.
Oh, before you go, let's just go back to the movie. Can't take him anywhere.